The Lemonade Diet. Purpose. To dissolve and eliminate toxins and congestions that have formed in any part of the body. To cleanse the kidneys and the digestive system. To purify the glands and cells throughout the entire body. To eliminate all unusable waste and hardened material in the joints and muscles. To relieve pressure and irritation in the nerves, arteries, and blood vessels. To build a healthy bloodstream. To keep youth and elasticity regardless of our years. When to use it. When sickness has developed, in all acute and chronic conditions. When the digestive system needs a rest and a cleansing. When overweight has become a problem. To assist in better assimilation and building. 3 to 4 times a year for all above uses, and will do wonders for less serious or mild conditions. The diet may be done more often for serious conditions. Longer periods, up to 40 days, may be safely followed for real serious cases. How to make it. Combine the juice of 1/2 lemon or whole small lime, approximately 2 tablespoonfuls, and 2 tablespoonfuls of sweetening to an 8-ounce glass of medium hot water. The sweetening must be used to properly balance the lemon and to achieve the desired results of cleansing and building. The various forms of sweetening may consist of all kinds of unsulfured molasses, Grandma's, Barbados, Louisiana, or Blackstrap. The various forms of molasses are slightly laxative. The most perfectly balanced sweetener of all is pure maple syrup, and is the most desirable in taste appeal. Many people who have trouble with the other types of sweeteners find the maple syrup as the perfect answer. It is only condensed and not refined. The pure sorghum is the next best sweetener, as it too has not been refined or altered or adulterated. It is very tasty and of good quality. These various sweeteners may be interchanged from time to time as one desires the change of taste. However, there is one exception. For those who have diabetes, the blackstrap molasses must be used, as it gives the necessary minerals the body needs for making the needed insulin and to make other balances in the blood sugar. The diabetic should start with only 1 teaspoonful of molasses for each glass, and then gradually increase the amount daily until the full amount is taken, 2 tablespoonfuls. Honey must not be used at any time. It is manufactured from the nectar picked up from the flowers by the bees, pre-digested, vomited, and stored for their future use with a preservative added. It is deficient in calcium and has many detrimental effects for the human being. Honey is strictly for the bees. Liquefying the skin and pulp and drinking that with the lemonade assists in cleansing by acting as a further laxative. At the same time, it helps to give tone and quality to the blood. It enables the blood to clot properly at the surface and to be free from clotting in the veins and arteries. This can assist in correcting many types of hemorrhages. It also gives additional taste appeal. Adding a dash of cayenne pepper to each glass of lemonade will give an additional lift and is a blood-building material. The cayenne also helps to break up mucus and stimulate increased elimination of the toxins. Mint tea may be used occasionally during this diet as a pleasant change and further assist in the cleansing. Its chlorophyll helps as a purifier, neutralizing many mouth and body odors that are released during the cleansing period. How often to use it? Take from 6 to 12 glasses of the lemonade daily during the waking period. As one gets hungry, just have another glass of lemonade. No other food should be taken during the full period of the diet. As this is a more complete balance of minerals and vitamins, one does not suffer the pangs of hunger. All solid food is turned into a liquid before it can be carried by the blood. The lemonade is already a food in liquid form. For those who are overweight, less molasses may be taken. For those underweight, more molasses may be taken. For those who are underweight and worried about losing more weight, remember, the only things that you can possibly lose are mucus, waste, and disease. Healthy tissue will not be eliminated. Many people who need to gain weight do so near the end of the diet. Never vary the amount of lemon juice per glass. About 6 glasses of lemonade a day are enough for those wishing to reduce. extra water may be taken as desired. Further information. In case of too frequent eliminations of the intestinal tract, less molasses may be used. In case of insufficient elimination, more molasses may be taken separately if desired. As this is a cleansing diet, the more you can assist nature to eliminate these poisons, the better. Remember, if you are upset, it is because you are not having sufficient elimination. Avoid this possibility by following the directions completely. Above all, be sure you have 2, 3, or more eliminations a day. This may seem unnecessary when not eating solid food, but this is nature's way of eliminating the waste it has loosened from the various cells and organs in the body. They must leave the body some way. It would be just the same as sweeping the floor around and around and never removing it from the house. The better the elimination, the more rapid will be the results. A laxative herb tea is found to be the best. It is even a good practice to take a good laxative herb tea right from the beginning, last thing at night and first thing in the morning. There are several good laxative teas. They are best taken in a liquid form. Buy them in your health food store. As it is necessary to bathe the outside of our body, so it is with the inside. Do not take enemas or colonics at any time during the cleansing diet or afterwards. They are unnecessary and can be extremely harmful. There is a much superior method of cleansing the colonic tract without the harmful effect of the colonics and enemas. This method will cleanse the entire digestive tract, while the colonics and enemas will only reach the colon or a small part of it. Colonics can be expensive, while the salt water is not. Prepare a full quart of lukewarm water and add 2 level, rounded for the Canadian quart, teaspoonfuls of sea salt. Do not use ordinary iodized salt. Drink the entire quart of salt and water first thing in the morning. The salt and water will not separate, but will stay intact and quickly wash quite thoroughly the entire tract in about 1 hour. Several eliminations will likely occur. The salt water has the same specific gravity as the blood, hence the kidneys cannot pick up the water, and the blood cannot pick up the salt. This may be taken as often as needed for proper washing of the entire digestive system. If the salt water does not work the first time, try adding a little more or a little less salt until the proper balance is found, or possibly take extra water with or without salt. This often increases the activity. Remember, it can do no harm at any time. The colon needs a good washing, but do it the natural way, the salt water way. It is quite advisable to take the herb laxative tea at night to loosen, then the salt water each morning to wash it out. If for some reason the salt water cannot be taken in the morning, then the herb laxative tea must be taken night and morning. Some people want to take pills or food supplements on the diet. This does not always produce the desired result. There are many reasons. As the lymphatic glands become clogged, they are no longer able to assimilate and digest even the best of foods. As we cleanse our body and free our cells and glands of toxins that clog and paralyze our assimilation, we free our various activities to do their proper job. Note on page 29 that all the vitamins and minerals may be found in the lemonade, and therefore do not need additional supply in most cases. Later, as we consume a more complete variety of foods, we find our source of vitamins and minerals complete in a form that is easily assimilated. Our source of good food is steadily being enlarged as we educate the people. Search these sources and rely on them for your food. The lemon is a loosening and cleansing agent with many important building factors. Its 49% potassium strengthens and energizes the heart, stimulates and builds the kidneys and adrenal glands. Its oxygen builds vitality. Its carbon acts as a motor stimulant. Its hydrogen activates the sensory nervous system. Its calcium strengthens and builds the lungs. Its phosphorus knits the bones, stimulates and builds the brain for clearer thinking. Its sodium encourages tissue building. Its magnesium acts as a blood alkalizer. Its iron builds the red corpuscles to rapidly correct all forms of anemia. Its chlorine cleanses the blood plasma. Its silicon aids the thyroid for deeper breathing. The molasses, sorghum, or maple syrup is an eliminator and builder. It also contains the Wilson loosening factor. The natural iron, copper, calcium, carbon, and hydrogen help to build the blood to normal and gives plenty of energy. It truly is a perfect combination for cleansing, eliminating, healing, and building. In the cleansing process, some people experience a tremendous stirring up and possibly feel worse for several days. It is not the lemonade which causes the trouble, but what the lemonade stirs up in the system that causes our dizziness and other disturbances. Vomiting may occur under certain conditions. Increased pain may be felt in the various joints of the body. Even dizziness may occur on certain days. If weakness develops at any time, it is the result of poisons circulating through the bloodstream, rather than a lack of food or vitamins. This diet gives a person all the vitamins, food, and energy necessary for the full 10 days or longer in a liquid form. Even though the lemon is an acid fruit, it becomes alkaline as it's digested and assimilated. It is our finest aid toward the proper alkaline balance. Alcoholics, smokers, and other drug addicts will receive untold benefits from this diet. The chemical changes and the cleansing remove the craving and the many possible deficiencies. Thus, the desire for these unnatural types of stimulants and depressants disappear. The usual cravings experienced and suffered in breaking away from drugs, alcohol, and tobacco no longer present themselves during and after this diet. It is truly a wonderful feeling to be free from slavery to these many habit-forming and devitalizing articles of modern living. Coffee, tea, and the various cola drinks, as habit-forming beverages, also are readily conquered with the marvels of the lemonade diet.